Hello everyone, this is Dr. Rahul Pandya. Welcome to our channel. In today's episode, we will discuss how to avoid the plagiarism. Before we begin, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe and hit the bell icon to receive the latest videos notifications. Also, if you find the episode informative, please do not forget to like and share. You may follow us on Facebook and Instagram. The links are posted in the description. During their early phase, many researchers and students are unaware of plagiarism. Plagiarism occurs when we copy someone else's ideas and present them as ours without citing the sources. In today's era of the internet, the information is easily accessible to everyone. Therefore, when writing the research papers, submitting the assignments, or research proposals, we copy certain information from various sources without citing them. Definitely, we can refer to the knowledge and information available in the literature. However, copying directly without citing them is a serious issue known as plagiarism. There are distinct methods to avoid the plagiarism. We will discuss the most common ones in today's episode. If you want to refer to the existing publications, the best practice is to paraphrase that information and cite the respective sources. Paraphrasing means rewriting the information in our own words without changing the original meaning. However, merely paraphrasing is not acceptable to avoid the plagiarism. Always cite the respective sources after the paraphrasing to acknowledge the credit to the authors. For example, the highlighted text in the green is paraphrased, and the respective source numbered from 1 to 4 are cited. The reference list, in general, comes at the end of the article and must reflect the detail of the references with the same numbers as cited. The formatting of the citations and references may differ from publisher to publisher. One can follow the detailed citation guidelines based on the targeted publisher. The citations are mandatory even if you use images, graphs, diagrams, pictures, photographs, and data. For example, the image shown at the right is taken from the source 1, and the respective source is cited and listed in the references. Moreover, citing any copyrighted material such as images, pictures is not sufficient if they are not published under the common creative licenses. One has to acquire the written approval from the respective publisher before the redistribution. This will help to avoid the copyright infringements. The third method to avoid the plagiarism is direct quoting followed by the citation. When we want to refer to the information text exactly as is published, we can quote the respective text without changing any word followed by citing the source. For example, the following text is acquired from source 1 and placed under the quotation mark. Furthermore, at the end of the quoted text, the source 1 from where the original text is borrowed is well cited and placed in the detailed reference list at the end of the article. However, too much of quoting is not advisable. Paraphrasing is always appreciated than the excessive quoting. Thank you very much for attending this episode. We will be creating new videos on research process regularly. Please subscribe to our channel to get the notifications of the latest videos. Before we leave, please do not forget to like and share the episode. Thank you very much.